Hello, Diva Dolls.
Hello, hello.
This is our face after a week of Supreme Court decisions.
When you first started speaking, I thought you were saying this is our voice now that it's July and it's no longer Pride.
Oh well, yeah.
Hey guys.
Yeah, this is the straightest pod ever.
Straight Pride.
The Straight Chat Podcast.
Today on the Straight Chat Podcast, American Girl.
We're gonna be talking about Yeah.
Let's talk about their backstories.
Transition.
How's everyone doing, first of all? Miranda, we just recorded a close friends of your whirlwind Disney trip, but
a whirlwind.
You wanna just hit us with the bullet points?
Yeah, sure. Quick, efficient Disney trip. It's the time where you're just standing outside and just sweat is just dripping down your back. But you know
what? I'm used to that in Florida, but all year round.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh, dripping.
Oh my god. Help! My god. Road Tiana's thought we weren't going to. You can hear about that on the pod as well. No, just overall really nice time. Good to be down there, you know? Great.
That's what I always say about Florida. It's good to be
down there. Oh, it's good to be home.
Welcome home, as they say.
Yes. We did drive by Abaco Key. We said hello.
Oh, yes. They haven't burned it down still? Wow.
No. It does look really just crummy right across the street from Evermore now, because Evermore is just stunning. It's so pretty. But yeah. It was great.
How
if you want to listen to more,
like
truly across the street,
right? Yeah,
like where all those car accidents always were.
Yes, yeah. That little turn, Diva.
Yes, you go just maybe 10 yards further, and that's one of the back entrances to Evermore.
I think my friend still lives in what are those apartments over there called?
Zen.
Zen. I think she still lives
Zen
in
Zen apartments.
Zen.
Sure.
Zen.
Who was like $600 more expensive than Abaco. For basically the same thing.
I'm sure now
they were any nicer.
They were just newer.
They were just newer. They had a nice pool.
Oh.
We had a nice pool.
Yeah, I guess. But there's just like shade.
I don't think I know what Abaco's
pool looks like. I think it was kind of hidden.
Actually
don't remember if I ever went on it.
We went to the pool one time.
Huh. I took my niece there one time. I think my niece Isabella.
You just dipped your knees into the pool.
No, I think my niece.
Dumb. Oh my god, dumb.
It does look like rents have gone down, RJ. We can get a 2-bed, 1-bath for $1,870.
Oh my god.
Because I think it was up to like $2,100 at a time.
Really? That's down a lot.
That's super affordable.
I think we should move back.
I wonder if they've got any. I think they have some 3 bedrooms for us, maybe. Let's see. I'm viewing all floor plans. 3 beds. Hold on. Let me tell you how much a 3-bed apartment is. It's only $2,050.
Honestly, and we could like under the table do an Airbnb, a close friend's Airbnb.
Like, well, that's what I was thinking.
Cash
like,
only. You know?
Do we pitch in on a group chat condo?
Is this our Airbnb condo?
You know who would invest on a group chat condo?
Jace.
Joy Silva.
Oh my god, you know it, girl.
She is like, where do I co-sign these papers?
Let's go.
Just let me do it.
Life is short, you know. Yes. I'm retired. I have to enjoy life. That's what she would say.
What building were we in, RJ?
Sixteen.
Oh, only building 15 is available.
16103.
16208 was me. Also, I just changed my address on my credit card back to Texas because I don't have that in-state, what's it called anymore? In-state annual pass anymore. Mm. I was like, I should probably change this back in case they ever have to send me a new card.
Mm. Probably.
Yeah, we could get a 3-bed, 2-bath apartment at Miss Abaco, and the our friends.
That's perfect for all five of us.
Yeah,
that's perfect.
Yeah.
Me and RJ in one room, Miranda and Jason one room, and
and me and
Casey in the bathroom,
and Winnie and Friedrich in one room. Yeah, it's great.
Our friends Robbie and Jesse, they just bought a house. They're moving houses. They bought a new build over at
you know, God. There's something about Orlando millennials, and they love a new build. They all look the exact same. I could tell you what their kitchen looks like. I could draw you right now their kitchen.
I could draw you the new build.
I can draw you their kitchen.
Yeah, and it's like they got basically like bigger.
It's by Flamingo Crossing.
Crazy. Yeah. It's like a house because right now they're at a townhome.
That's nice.
Well, Diva, good luck, girl.
Good luck, babe. You're there. The long haul. There.
Well,
we briefly touched on it.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Casey, as our resident American girl historian, because you have started listening to the Isabella Nikki audiobook, haven't you?
I have. And it's just filled with references to AOL Instant Messenger, Blockbuster Video.
Sure.
Wanting to rent the Parent Trap movie.
It's actually only available to people who went on the Chicago trip.
Oh my God. Yes.
Sorry.
They gave us a QR code. Girls.
Right now, Miranda, you are an Isabel because Isabel is trying to get all her friends to do the Spice Girls dance, but there's a cooler girl that's like, no, we need to do NSYNC instead.
What
the drama in this audiobook?
Drama.
Is it on
and
Libby?
Nikki found some little skater girl at the skate park. I think Nikki's a lesbian.
Sounds very coded.
Who's the author of this? Did they watch It Takes Two with Mary-Kate and Ashley? I think it's probably an episode of It Takes Two. That's what's happening.
This is like AI, mama. Someone said write a book from two girls in 1999, and oh my God, Nikki is so scared of Y2K. She is so afraid of Y2K and the bug. And her mom is a woman in STEM. She is working on making sure that bug does not mess with their
coding.
She's a
girls who code.
My library does not have Meet Isabella and Nikki audiobook.
Well, you better request it, honey. That. You said I paid taxes, okay?
I pay
and I deserve
taxes.
To hear their stories. Why are we silencing
women?
Say that.
Because you know who else is silencing women?
I was going to say.
How much is
the Supreme Court?
Men.
Oh.
Straight men.
Well, yes, that one's a good one.
And also,
but... Yeah, so we knew what was happening when we talked about American Girls last week. We knew another podcast was going to come out on the same day.
We did not know for sure. There was a highly probable.
The tweet was very obvious.
Yeah.
Right, but we didn't know. I'm not saying we had somehow background information.
Yeah.
But then.
Sometimes the hint is like a complete, like, it's one thing, but it's another thing.
They do that purposefully.
But then, Adam came into the group chat at 1 a.m.
No, RJ did.
No, it was RJ.
Oh, wow, RJ was blacked out. I thought Adam
got the email.
Casey's talking about that.
So I sent the PTR, but like yesterday, today?
Yeah, today at 1 a.m.
That was me.
Oh, the today was Adam. Yes.
Adam
the Try Guys, the Try Guys pod,
and was that guy in the beard the new Try Guy?
They have like a rotating.
Oh, they have a rotating guy because Eugene's gone.
Eugene is famously.
Yeah, I think yes, he left after all of that happened, right?
He just left like a month ago, 2 months ago.
Oh.
Yeah.
So now it's just. Why does anyone know who the Try Guys are?
Who the Try Guys are? I know. It's because.
I only know because of the scandal.
Of the Ned. Yeah. The Ned of it all.
I knew the Try Guys technically before because I had watched. Because we did watch some of their stuff.
Yeah. And I knew Eugene. Eugene was always my favorite one, obviously, because of queer.
Well, yeah,
because
he's the Asian one.
He's the. That is. And now it's literally it's just what? Straight dudes?
Yeah.
It's just straight dudes.
Yeah, it's just
That's it. Just talking guys about being
American girl talking dolls. About American girl dolls. Why did we start the cultural conversation when the girls have been here?
Why are we carrying who is the listening? Zeitgeist on our back?
Yeah, who's listening? The spy?
Who's the mole?
I think Marie likes the mole.
Come into the chat. Shut yourself.
Who likes the mole?
Jessica.
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 Jessica's in Japan. Jessica's
busy,
life.
Girl. Trying
she's,
different.
She's too busy. She can't be the mole. She can't be the mole.
She's been going to McDonald's. I love that we're just at. She's been going to the McDonald's in Japan, sending us pictures of them. She said, RJ, she said the shrimp sandwich thing at McDonald's. She said big old chunks of shrimp in it.
Oh, yeah.
So good.
I might have to try it.
Yeah.
After my little egg sandwich that you're supposed to get from 7-Eleven, apparently.
Yeah, Adam Noecker, 1 a.m.
That's the legal name. My God. Yeah, the government name.
Girl, your Twitter name was basically your name for like years.
Well, it's not anymore. Now that I've up and I have 2,000 people who listen to my asinine tweets about how hot Asian men are.
but Adam will still reply to just shit posts, and there was that one tweet about
my God, I have three options for my go off today. I will not make this mine, but I will talk about this. There was a video that a man posted, and he was like, oh, just bought groceries for my family. I have 6 kids. And he went to Trader Joe's.
Dumb.
And he scans his whole thing. And at the end, his total for a week's worth of groceries is $444. And the whole point is to be like, look how expensive groceries are. We can't afford anything in America nowadays. And then I sat there and I was like, okay, but assuming it's a two-parent household, that's 8 people. $444 divided by 8 is like $50 a person. And then I was like, let's say there's no way they do. But if you ate all 21 meals in a week, 3 meals a day, 7 days a week, that's $2.60 per meal per person. Why are we? That seems extremely affordable to me. Does it not? Am I crazy? But it's just people engaging with it, being like, Joe Biden. Period.
Well, first of all, don't buy groceries at Trader Joe's if you're pinching the penny, diva.
That's an Aldi situation.
That's an Aldi situation.
That's an Aldi. That's a Costco.
Buy in bulk. You have 6 children. Buy in bulk. What are you talking about?
Why are you not buying in bulk?
Why are you not, honey? But Adam fully replied.
I've got Joe who makes chicken for himself every day for lunch. I've gotten him on the. I buy him a big old thing of chicken.
You buy a big old thing of chicken. He cooks it
and he's good for 2 weeks.
Yeah,
because he was buying just from HEB, and I'm like, Mama, we can get double the amount of
chicken.
Keep it in the freezer, bitch, and pop one out.
No, he cooks it all at once and just lets.
Oh wow!
That's very brave. Very brave of him. I couldn't do it. I'd be like, I've got 7 more meals of this, and now I'm sick of it.
I don't know what is in my freezer currently, right now?
Mm-hmm. Gideon's. Because, I walked past yesterday. I was just walking around Springs, window shopping, if you will. And I see the line is 7 people deep. And
for
I go,
what
oh,
store?
How long?
Gideon's.
For Gideon's.
Oh, for Gideon's.
And I go, oh, how long is the virtual queue? And they're like, this is it.
Oh,
and so I go,
you crossed the picket line.
Let me see what's the month. And it was
did we ever reach a consensus on what we were supposed to do? Are we supposed to care? I don't think I care.
Did you get a vibe in there that there was conflict?
There were tons of them working. Like, I don't know. It was fine.
So weird.
Oh, how was
lemon crumb? What was the cold brew? Was there a seasonal cold brew?
Oh, yes. And it was like an orange.
Was it shaken or was it stirred? That's what we need to know. Did people need to know if it was shaken or if it was stirred?
That's what I should have done. I should have ordered a cold brew and commanded it to be shaken.
And did they demand a tip?
I mean, it's just their little tablet. What was the tip situation? It was automatically on 20, but it was 15, 18, 20. Or no, 18, 20, 22.
How did they, what did they, say anything when they flipped the screen over?
Nope. But I'm like, you're putting cookies into a bag, a box in a bag.
I don't think that should be tipped.
20%.
I really don't want to sound like a damn conservative or a damn boomer, but there are, when we went to Astor Hall for our lunch before our lunch at the American Girl Cafe, you order at kiosks and then you go pick up from different windows depending on what station you ordered from. But it's all in one kiosk. And at the kiosk, it asks if you would like to leave a tip. Who is that going to? Yeah, I have to know.
This happened the same thing when we went to a Minnesota Twins game last month or 2 months ago, whenever it was. You go and get your own drink out of the fridge and you check out yourself. And
that's it says Moody.
To tip. And I'm like, this lady is right here waiting for something to go wrong, but she didn't do anything. I'm not tipping all the anyone. Girl does,
yeah, they at Moody, all they have to check your ID.
But you are
self-checkouting and it's like, and guess who leaves 20%?
Joe.
The man. Joe. We just spent $40 on two hot dogs, a beer, and a soda.
Casey, when you bought that man his chicken breasts, you should have showed him your damn phone. Please press 20, 18, or 15.
Absolutely.
Girl.
I sent him a Venmo request yesterday for consulting fees whenever he asked me a
whenever
question.
Whenever he asks you for an opinion. That's the thing. It's these like new marketplace, like you flip the iPad. And
I have
like,
no, I want to be very clear. I have no problem tipping bartenders, tipping wait staff.
Coffee shops,
you're doing a special service. Yeah. You're creating coffee specific blended beverages. Fine. All of that above board. I have no problem. If I go to your like Panera Bread and they're like, what do you want to leave as a tip? That's the sole function of your job is just to do that. When I order my Potbelly sandwich and the app is like, what tip would you like to leave? I'm making your job easier by not coming in and bothering you. Like I am submitting an order online. Yeah. You are receiving that order. You have to speak to no one. And then all I do is pick it up from the little table.
Yeah.
What are we talking about? Pay workers as much as they deserve to be paid. I am happy to pay more for the sandwich to offset their pay.
Yes.
Why? Is it like now you? Oh, bothers me. My mom still tips 15%. So there are some people that you won't fix. So
I tip for to go because they're having to like someone is having to package that up and do whatever. Like I will tip for to go.
I don't tip for to go if it's a restaurant. I will tip like 10% for to go because like. Mm-hmm. It was an order that they could have like been, but I don't know who's getting that tip at a restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, who's like, the waiter? At like a Chili's, it's going to the little girly that's manning the to-go station and packing up the order, putting it in the bag and whatever.
And forgetting the napkin. Yeah, yeah.
Are you into some of the places that they'll just say like they'll add the service charge or they'll be like,
so
the prices are raised because
Alamo Drafthouse does this. Mm. There's a big message that comes up on the screen that says, you will be charged an 18% service fee on your tab today. If no extra tip is necessary, but if you'd like to, you to give your server extra, that's
Which is what the point of a tip is.
And like they're actual servers, you know, because they're like they're running around. I'm making them refill of Diet Coke.
Every third scene.
Every third scene.
Minutes.
Fill her up.
Yeah.
Fill her up. So they're getting, I mean, I know Joe always gives them more than than just the 18. I mean, I don't ever see it, so.
That's what I know he gets.
You need to start.
You get, well, Casey, you get your own tip.
Oh.
Because even when they messed up our order this last week, the girl, like, we had to wait till after because they didn't bring us our checks. Because usually, you know, in these dine-in movie theaters, around the 20 to 30 minute mark, they bring around your checks. Because they did last call like 45 minutes beforehand, but the last check, our check never came. And everyone just left. They're like, okay, whatever, because, you know, they just take out 18% or whatever. That's fine. But we had ordered fried pickles, and they never came. So I was like, well, we need to get our check so we can ask them to take the fried pickles off.
Yeah.
So once the movie was over and everything, no one ever came back in. So we, like, walked out and, like, found a server and then found out that, like, the guy that was doing it, he was, like, fairly new. He was all, like, flummoxed and stuff. And a girl, like, was like, oh, I'll fix your check and bring it back to you. And she brought it back. And she's like, here's this. You know, you don't have to sign it or whatever because it'll just do whatever. But here's the receipt. And he's like, oh, no, I still want to sign it because he, like, still was going to give him more than whatever. Yeah.
Sure.
But, yeah.
The price of the pickles, probably.
The price of the pickles.
Because you know what, Mama? They took off my drink as well and boxed up those pickles to go. So, of course, we're going to give you a little extra.
Absolutely.
You
just made her day. Happy to do.
You just made her day.
Made her day.
So, Diva, you've seen Inside Out 2, Casey? Uh-huh.
Yes, the
Miranda
Diva.
Miranda have not.
I have.
You have?
Yeah.
Adam,
have you?
Adam really wants to see it.
We
could go this weekend. It's 4th of July weekend. We can see the Alamo.
We can see it on Thursday.
We can do our Alamo draft house.
Patriotic.
We could do an Alamo draft house. Cheese puffs.
Cream puffs.
Cheese puffs. That'll be the new
name. I stand for our three colors, anger, white, and sadness. Honey.
Okay.
Who's white?
There's no white emotion, so I couldn't pick.
The girlies are.
Do you need me to explain it, Miranda?
Inside Out 2 is doing so
jokes
well.
Jokes are always better when they're.
Inside Out 2 is doing so well that the girlies are so scared of Moana 2 now, so they've moved Wicked.
They moved her. First of all, I love Scott Gustin. I need him to stop tweeting about the box office of Inside Out. He has tweeted, I am not kidding, at least 7 updates of the box office of Inside Out 2. And I'm like, I don't need, move on. You can do it the first weekend, even the second weekend, but it's consistent. I'm like, that's enough. Yeah, they moved up Wicked.
We said Wicked and Casey left.
5 days.
Bye.
They moved up Wicked 5 days. To compete now with Gladiator 2. And now they're calling it like stupid.
No, this is forced. Barbenheimer will never be repeated.
All the girls are
she got a haircut yesterday. She's beautiful today.
I thought you were about to pick her up with just one
hand. I thought it started raining. Oh, but Jace is here, so she can. Her new thing now is when it's storming in the middle of the night, she just goes and stands.
Well, get Chase on the pod. It's straight pride. Get him up here.
Jace. It's straight month.
Jace.
Congrats.
He says, what?
Ally.
Never mind.
Yeah, so they moved up Wicked because it's not going to compete with. Is that what we're doing?
Is that what we're doing now?
Is that what we're worried about?
I thought it was weird that the two of them were opening on the same weekend, mostly because they're similar
family films.
Audiences. They're similar audiences, so why would you have them choose between?
Yeah.
Why make them choose?
I saw someone tweet, "Oh, this is such a bummer because I wanted to see both." I wanted to do a double feature, and it took everything in my body to be like, Wicked is not going to be out of theaters by the time Moana 2
Mama,
opens,
Wicked
I promise.
Wicked is not having a limited release, Diva. What are you talking about? That's so funny.
So
yeah, like I guess I obviously was planning on saying Wicked first over Moana 2. But that's just me.
I'm famously not a Moana, so.
Oh really?
I was not planning on saying
Moana shook me, honey.
I know. Uh-huh. But this was our big.
But I will say, like, with Moana, I mean, like, I don't know. It's not like I've had the urge to re-listen to it, but like the music to me was still so evocative that I was like, I could listen to the soundtrack a lot.
Oh, and so yeah. It's so smart that they did not use Lin-Manuel again. Really just like jump ship on that one for sure. That's brilliant.
You probably couldn't afford him anymore.
There's no
way. It's probably that he's using... my guess is that he was busy, but I don't know how that works when you make animation and it takes 7 years to make a movie anyway. Right. So.
Yeah.
Well, did you not watch the Frozen documentary?
Or was it that? Was it that?
Oh, the girls don't know.
Oh, the girls don't know this. This is my new thing. Or was it because they were like, well, we're not going to afford him for the show, the Moana show we're making. And then halfway through, they were like, we could just make this a movie, but they were already locked in on Miss Girl.
That's probably it. Miss Girl.
Who's doing the music?
The girls who wrote the Bridgerton TikTok musical. Abby.
Oh, perfect.
Abby
Lee Miller.
Abby Lee Miller.
Honey. Abby Lee Miller.
I
want to
see it
back. When I hear this great voice.
Abby Lee Miller was music and lyrics are by JoJo Siwa. It's JoJo a real Siwa. Tour de force. Tour
Don't
de force.
Even talk about
Do not
about
speak
her.
JoJo existence into the Disney universe. I would simply implode.
I don't know.
She's in the Disney Parks universe every week.
Every damn week.
I don't know. Ever since she said fuck all my fucking haters at her like last show. I don't know if she,
And then they said no.
And then they booed her. Yes. Did you see this tweet, Adam?
Yeah, girl.
Oh my god, that's
I
so
just don't
funny.
Feel like giving her energy.
Yeah.
That's just my take
I'm
on JoJo Siwa.
So
She's just one of those, you know, like
she's just one of these young girls.
One of those kids that it's like, just let them run their energy out and then
they'll get
take
tired
a nap.
And take a
yeah.
Nap.
Not when you can't take a nap when you're on cocaine.
Oh. Karma's a bitch, honey.
Karma's a bitch.
But anyway.
She should have known better.
Well,
anyway.
Aren't we all glad that the spiritual successor of the Galactic Star Cruiser is still alive and well with the cabins at Disney's Fort Wilderness Resort because they did.
Miranda's thrilled. She told us all about it. She thinks they look incredible. She can't wait to stay.
Miranda loves them. She cannot
love
to stay
them.
In them.
I would be happy to stay in a cabin again. So F all you.
I know, but I miss the cabin. Give me the cabin.
I'm staying at a cabin, I want it to look like a cabin.
I don't want to look like I won the HGTV Tiny Home competition.
See, I do. You know, I want that.
Give me that.
I want that.
All I see is like rich landlord on Airbnb. That's all I see.
My biggest thing about how they look on the outside is like they're going to look so dated in like 7 years. Like you're going to look at them and be like, that is so clearly 2023, 2024. Like,
I mean, that's like how we all look at like the Magnolia homes with Chip and Joanna, you know?
Yes.
Like,
oh, yes, like, yeah. Shiplap,
bitch. It's Barn very doors. Much that. Yeah. Millennial gray. Like, it's... yeah. It's one of those things.
Famously, I work in real estate. And I have to tell you that anytime I look at photos and I see those gray laminate floors, I get so sad. I just, it's
especially
such a bummer.
In Chicago when they're like,
it's already Chicago. Gray.
Like, I mean, Chicago has a lot of homes that
That's
are.
That's Casey's review
so
of Chicago, by the way. So
it's,
damn
she's gray.
Gray.
Bitch, she's gray.
I don't know. Yeah, because it's like they take out all the, like, the original hardwood in those homes.
Yes.
Like,
and just in put
the
in
natural. Yeah.
Final.
Because like the city still has like really nice brownstones too.
Yeah.
And then you go in and it's like
And then you mess them up. Oh,
I
poor
know.
Babes.
It's so sad.
I mean, like, I have vinyl flooring, but I live in a suburb in Des Moines. Like, I'm not paying for real wood, you know? Like, this didn't have wood before. Like, it's not like I took out the wood flooring and...
Right.
Right.
So, right. We're not talking about me, okay? I don't have the budget for that.
Didn't your house go through new floors and it was, like, a big ordeal?
We took out the carpet on the first floor.
Yes, that's what it was.
Carpet.
We took out the carpet.
But anyway,
it was just plywood underneath, wasn't it?
The beds at the cabin at the Explore Wilderness Resort. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The bunk beds at the cabins were inspiration directly from the Star Cruiser bed.
Doesn't it feel crazy that the Star Cruiser is more famous now than it ever was during the entirety of it being an actually existing thing? I feel like that's crazy. They just, I feel like
Jenny Nicholson brought Star Cruisers like, to the masses.
Because, like,
I know this was her point.
About that, like, influencer marketing is like, people don't buy it if it feels fake.
Yeah.
They're like, I can tell you didn't actually do this. It's weird, like, blah, blah, blah. But, like, I watched that full review and it made me, maybe I wouldn't have enjoyed myself, but I wanted to try it out just to be like, is it really like that? Like, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I almost wish it still existed so I could see how
like fake it feels.
Yeah.
Because Miss Jenny Nicholson was nominated for a Las Culturistas Culture Award.
Amazing.
Because of that video. Yeah.
That's so, I didn't know that. That's so funny.
Highest honor.
The highest it honor is, in the land.
Truly.
Igatka.
But that's I don't know how to transition. Casey, how was your show on
speaking from a galaxy far, far away.
Let's take
a quick trip to Slime City, Casey.
Let's take a quick
trip. As mayoress of Slime City.
She is absolutely mayor of that troop.
I mean, I named the bitch.
You did. Girl, you were there. You have the key to the city.
Mm-hmm. I was presented my key.
Okay,
to the
city. How was the show?
How did your first improv show go?
My first improv show as not a student.
But a professional.
It was great. It was a packed house. Wow. You know, right. We had
like how
we
many?
Did have, like
what
a nice little like coupon code for friends and fam. So when our coach texts us on Sunday, he's like, the show is really close to selling out. We've got like 55 pre-sales, you know, like,
wow,
they sold 55 tickets before the night even started, or, you know, before the event.
Wow.
And they were doing like a discount at the bar, so like that was cool for, I mean, Joe and his friends. Because Joe brought two of his coworkers, and then Be Freedom Freelac, Miss Austin Office, they came as well.
You had a corporate outing.
Uh-huh. Yes. I am going to be facilitating an improv, you know, in person so that.
Oh, yeah.
We can get better mind meld, you know?
Yeah.
We need to sync.
I thought that's what girls do when they spend a lot of time together. They start to
say that. It is what girls do. But it was really good. We were the second improv troupe to go. I will say that everyone I talked to said we were great.
We were the best one.
We were the best. But no, it was really fun. It was just really fun to, you know, be back on stage and you know, not feel too scared.
Yeah.
Why are you laughing?
Because you're so charming, Casey. I can't help but laugh.
You just can't help but laugh.
I can't help but make them laugh.
But I'm hoping that we can, you know, really build on, you know, everything. And we're, you know, I'm hanging out with some of them tomorrow night, so we're just trucking along, making new friends,
keeping it fresh.
Love that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the
so next show will be at the end of July, the last Sunday in July. But yeah, but I'm excited to, you know.
Is it once a month?
Yeah, the show's once a month. We meet like every Sunday to like either practice or just hang out. And then we do our show.
But honestly, yeah, there's a lot to be said for that. It's so hard to make friends as adults.
Yeah.
So you have to do it in an activity. Nice. Like yeah.
It has to be an activity. And that was a big reason why I got into improv.
Yeah.
Was like to just like meet people that I wasn't working with or trying to date.
Yeah. So. And Casey's not joining any softball leagues anytime soon. So
absolutely not.
Pickleball
could be a moment for you, Casey. No.
We have
of the four of us, Miranda's gonna be the first one to
I'm not playing pickleball. You got
Miranda's
me?
Miranda's the pickleball.
Why am I the pickleball? I feel like RJ would be the pickleball of the four of us.
I would do like a badminton.
That's the same. It's a racket sport.
It's a thinner racket.
Yeah, that is so cute.
That is so cute.
That is actually really sweet.
This was gifted to me, hashtag gifted from Austin Office for my cooperation
and hard work for Pride, honey. Absolutely.
Hard work.
Wow. Yes. Is there not a pickleball Barbie? I'm surprised that that's not a thing.
There probably is. I'm sure.
I mean, there's definitely a tennis Barbie. So
well, when we get to the 2020s American Girl doll, she's going to be playing pickleball.
Oh, 100%. Yes.
What would be her name?
Without a doubt.
It'll be like...
It's literally... genuinely,
it's something with like a Lee, L-E-I-G-H, like an Everly.
Or it's like a word, it's like Sage.
It's going to be like Gabriella or something like that.
No, it's going to be like...
No, Gabriella is too like Gabriella's 90s, 2000s.
It's going to be Sage.
It's going to be like Oakley.
Oakley. Forest.
Oakley. I could see that.
Yeah, it's spelled O-A-K-L-E-I-G-H.
On my FYP on TikTok, here we go.
Okay. 2023's top 10 baby names for boys. Okay. Number 10,
Hunter.
William.
Oh.
Number 9, Lucas.
Okay. Number these eight, are 90s names.
Yeah. Number 8, but boys' names very rarely change. Number 8, Henry. 7 is Theodore.
Wow.
6 is Mateo.
Wow. Mateo from
five is Elijah. 4 is James. And then we're gonna head into 3 names that are so current. I feel like I know 6 children that are named these. 3 is Oliver, 2 is Noah, and 1 is Liam.
I know Noah was like the big one maybe in 2022.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Liam and Noah I know have been in the top 5 for the past like 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, female names for 2023 babies. 10 is Luna. 9 is Evelyn.
Luna's a cat.
Oh, that's Evelyn's a baby name that's on my list, so that's kind of upsetting actually.
8 is Ava, AVA.
Oh, Ava's coming back.
7 is Isabella.
My niece's name is Isabella.
6 is Mia.
These are names that are definitely like these are millennials. These are coming back. Having babies. Yeah.
5 is Sophia. 4 is Amelia.
Earhart.
3 is Charlotte. 2 is Emma. And 1 is Olivia.
Wow. Oh, okay.
Wow.
I know Eloise is going around now again as well.
Isn't that Charlotte and Emily? Aren't those the Bronte sisters? Oh, yeah. Emma. Great.
Interesting.
I saw some reel and it was like, and it was some lady at like some, you know, it was a, I think her website is like Nameberry or something. Mm-hmm. And like literally the names on this are just like, so like Royal, Hadley, Zyla, Rosalind.
See, Hadley is like more of the energy.
H-A-D. Right. L-E-I-G-H. Yeah.
Oh, for a girl.
Oh. Rosalind, yeah. Tinsley, Micah,
Paisley.
Paisley, P-A-I-S-L-E-I-G-H.
What is it when your cousin has a baby? Is he your second cousin?
It's like your first cousin.
First cousin once removed. I have a first cousin once removed named Tinsley, T-I-N-S-L-E-Y.
I'm going to go through a list of my first cousin once removed named, okay?
Please do.
Xavier, fine.
Okay.
Octavia, mm-hmm. Zahara, mm-hmm. Jersey.
No.
Xander.
Are these real people?
These are my first cousins once removed.
Okay.
Nova.
Xander.
Nova.
No.
There's more that I can't think of their names right now. Raya.
For those of you that don't know, listeners, Miranda has 600 cousins. That's not that's barely a joke.
That is true. I could keep going, but I'm blanking.
There were 300 people at her wedding, and 85% of them were family.
That's
members.
Why I'm like, I had cousins. 300. Yeah, just the cousins. Like, because God forbid, don't invite.
Okay, let me tell you. I just want to read these boys' names.
Yeah.
Shay, Teddy, Howard, Khalid, Bode, B-O-D-E, Harley, Jax with two X's, Ozias, Casper, which...
Casper! I mean,
bitch. Okay, bitch.
Bitch, I would name my baby Casper. Would. Can I keep you?
Can I keep you?
And Frankie.
I would not Frankie Grande. I would keep Shay. I liked Shay.
I
like Shay as a boy.
When I was in high school, I had a little flirtationship with a boy named Shay.
The boy. I love the boy named Shay.
Shay's a great unisex name.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Great unisex name.
I actually like Taylor, funny enough, as a unisex name too.
Taylor's a good unisex name, I think.
Yeah.
What about Audley?
I went to high school with a girl named Audley.
Really?
Yes.
Audily.
Ottillie.
Ottillie.
You know what?
Echo is an interesting one.
I'm surprised people aren't naming their children like Odette. You know, like the Swan Princess. Odette.
Oh yeah.
Aurora. No Auroras anymore.
I know what's an Aurora and they call her. I know a classmate of mine's baby's name is Aurora and they call her Rory.
They don't go by Briar Rose?
Oh my God, they should.
They should.
I have another, not first cousin once removed. It's my dad's cousin's daughter. Her daughter's name is Annie James. And I'm like 100% positive that she did not mean to name her after the Parent Trap.
That's Parent Trap.
Yeah, like I'm like 100% positive it is not based on the Parent Trap, but they call her wild. Annie James.
That's just where it ended up.
Like not, they never call her Annie. They call her Annie James. I was like, well, that's Parent Trap.
That's
which is it's super cute, like lovely.
I love when girls have like a middle name that's a traditionally boy, masculine name.
Yeah,
I agree. All right. Well, should we go off now that we're, you know,
what are
sure,
we?
Sure, Casey's up first.
Casey, go ahead.
She is up. She's putting her toys away. Okay, we're going to go off.
I'll go.
Yeah, you have three.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I went off about one already. We already talked about the Try Guys, so I have to use my third one.
Oh, your third option.
Wow.
Option three.
Right. Well, I'm just going to wait for Casey.
Is that Padme?
That is a Padme shirt.
Wait, that's so funny. So cool. Now, that's a name. When is Padme going to be in top 10?
Put her up. 2025. Call it.
All right, Adam, it's time to go off.
During our close friends chat earlier, Miranda talked about how she was at the Kiss Goodnight for the first day's operations of the new Ever After store at Disney Springs, to which I had to get an explanation of what store that was because I could not remember because it's such a generic name. But then when I remembered, I was like, well, let me look up and see what the girl looks like. I'm curious because she was like, oh, it's all kawaii now. It's like the Disney emoji game or whatever, Emoji Blitz. And I was like, oh, well, this is fun. So I found there's no way the Disney Springs store is going to have a good photo of it or the Disney Springs website. I found, unfortunately, I did go to WWNT. I apologize, but I went and looked through their photos. And Mama, when I tell you that this is garbage, RJ's going to pull it up right now. And I don't understand why. Just say it's like a pop-up. Just say it's like we're just going to retheme this anytime, whatever. This is giving Communicore Hall all over again. Mm-hmm. It is an emoji store, and yet the only thing that is like colorful is just the like cutout prints that you got done for like $5 from FedEx. Like, paint the walls, girl. There's no, the walls are millennial gray, and then they just printed out the emojis and stuck them on the wall. I just like, why is this? Why am I looking at these things being like, I can do better? I should not be going to Disney Springs being like, I have better ideas than this. I can do better.
Yeah.
Sorry, yeah. I shouldn't.
They got the wide format printer out and they went to town in that
I understand office. That you, it's in the like nicer part of Disney Springs, so maybe it would be weird to like make it really a really bright aesthetic, but like, then
was
don't
it still
make
the same sign? Did they keep the sign?
Well, no, it's the new name, which I think is just Disney Ever After.
Oh, I see.
It's bad. I don't know, guys. It's not good. It's getting worrisome. I'm worried.
It had a queue every time I walked past it, and I walked past it like maybe 3 or 4 times throughout the weekend when I went at Kiska night. It did not have a queue, but also again, I will preface that I was upset that
MickeyBlog.com. Can I open that?
Yeah.
Blog Mickey.
Okay. It was.
Oh, it just says Ever After.
But the thing is, the main attraction is the create your own headband.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And I'm glad that they're all still in stock from what I'm understanding, because God forbid this main attraction of this store sells out of the headbands like
and
Disneyland
then what?
Did. And then what? And then what?
I don't understand. I don't know, guys. It's just like a bummer. I'm just bummed. Maybe I shouldn't be. Maybe I'm the fool. But
I guess it's
giving Communicore Hall.
My whole thing was that this is fine as a concept, whatever. But why would you just not make it a new store?
Yeah.
Why? I feel like you could easily just make this as a part of that one store that used to be the Harley
Disney
Davidson
style.
One. Disney
yes.
style.
Yeah. Yes. This yeah. I, it is it. It's like a Disney style.
Because I like the Disney style store. I think that store is really cute.
It's cute.
Yes, I love the Disney style store.
And look, it's us, besties.
It is besties. Us.
Aww.
I love this castle emoji.
Right over the exit sign. Great.
I guess I didn't even realize that, yes, they are all emoji blitz faces. Yep.
That's
like
just so weird.
And coming from someone who used to play a lot of emoji blitz, Adam.
I loved emoji blitz. I loved emoji blitz.
I did. It's true.
And look, Miranda, look, I'm being influenced.
Aperol yes. spritz.
Still summer. We love. Oh, and they have the recipe, so you know it's a proper.
What is Sprite Chill?
What? Huh?
What is that?
Oh, Sprite Chill, cherry lime.
Ooh, I love cherry.
I can't believe these ads are getting us.
Click it.
Click the ad.
I mean, sure, I guess they painted the boxes that the displays sit in.
Yeah,
that
and like the displays, the square displays. Those new plushes are really cute, though. The little baby plushes, they're so cute.
The, what's her name, Mei Ling?
They finally had the Lotso ears, but I guess Disney World's always had them. Disneyland was where we couldn't find them.
So you said these headbands, like they're a thing all over. So when you go to Asia, they'll also have...
Hong Kong has the majority of the characters of them. I don't know if Tokyo or Shanghai do, but they have like a bunch of characters, like all of the Inside Out to even like Anxiety. They have Pixar, like the Pixar ball. They have lots of different options. And they have the ones that they're offering here, like Mickey, Minnie, Donald, Daisy, Chip and Dale. These are what they offered at Disneyland, and they literally sold out in 3 days and have still to this day not restocked. And that's been since, April?
RJ.
Miranda, did you not ride the debut
new green and yellow
the virgin scene? Sail? What is it called?
Oh, no, the friendship boat.
The maiden
friendship
voyage. Five.
The maiden voyage. The virgin sail.
The friendship
sail.
Five. New paint Damn. Job.
Oh, I missed
you
that.
Didn't break the champagne bottle over it?
May 28th, girl.
May 28th, no, oh. Yeah.
You just missed it.
That looks like John Deere in the water.
Perfect for Mead Island.
And you know, the friendship boats are so fucking hot inside.
They're so hot. Oh, they refuse to open the windows.
It's no. awful.
It's terrible. All right. Speaking of friendship boats, I'll go off.
Ooh. All right, Case. Oh, Case. All right, Miranda.
Okay, Winnie. It's time
okay,
to go
Winnie,
off.
It's time to go Thank off. You.
Okay, so for Jace's birthday, we also did something that Jace has never done before, and Jace has never been to Jelly Rolls. So we went to Jelly Rolls on a Saturday night. Sure. Thankfully, we know one of the managers, so we didn't have to pay cover, bless, which is why we went. We go in there. I love Jelly Rolls. When Jelly Rolls is like, when they're so, like, they're so good, they're so fun. One of the pianists there, he was actually, on the Wish when I was on the Wish and he played in Nightingales, which is the piano bar in Nightingales. So it was nice to have him there. It was great. You guys, it was completely full. Nobody was doing anything. They were all sitting at their tables,
lounging
on their phones, not speaking to each other, not singing along, not clapping, not dancing, nothing. Ew. Nothing. It was the worst vibe ever. It was truly, like, I was, like, upset. And, like, we were feeling very good at this moment. And so we were up, we were dancing. We were in the back first. We found a table. We went up first. There was, like, a, not a bachelorette party, but it was a bridal shower. And they came, yeah, I didn't know that's a thing now. But the bridal shower came to Jelly Rolls, and she was dressed as, like, a bachelorette. Bride, whatever. We found a table for them, so they were at least dancing. But it was literally
they're
just
like living
two of our tables and no one else.
What was the age?
Older, like maybe like younger 40s, mid 40s. But I was like, y'all paid maybe like a $30
cover to sit?
To come on a Saturday night at a piano bar? Like, come on. It was... There was not, that's true. They weren't playing, but they did play, Freelax says, Not Enough Sweet Caroline. They did play Journey's Don't Stop Believin', which is typical.
That gets them. Yeah.
It didn't. It did not. It was so awful. So after that, we went over to Atlantic Dance Hall. We get into Atlantic Dance Hall. We just go like onto the dance floor immediately. We were there for 30 seconds, and all of a sudden, this group of Gen Z, it was like a boy and a girl, come up to Jace, and they go, Macklemore, what are you doing here?
What?
And then they like walked away, and I was like already like so riled up from Jelly Rolls about how everybody sucked so bad, and I literally watched them, and I was like, what just happened? Are you kidding me? And then they were like giggling to each other as they walked away, and I was, and like one of them was recording, so it is probably on TikTok somewhere. Like, if a listener could try and find this clip, please let me know.
If we say it all into our phone, surely
it'll come up.
Macklemore, Atlantic Dance Hall.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? We found Macklemore at Disney World.
First of all, did they say Macklemore or Macklemore? They didn't even pronounce it correctly?
I don't know. Girl, I don't know. But I'm not pronouncing it correctly.
Jace was hate crime.
Jace was hate crime as a white man.
So we left. And I was like, if they were going to look at me, I would have flipped them off at that moment in my life.
Or thrown them into the lagoon.
They didn't even but like we immediately just like looked at each other and we were like, no. And we just left. We were gone. We were like, that's enough. This is not. And then as we were leaving, we looked at the bouncer. We're like, that sucked. And he goes, I could have told you that. And we were like, yeah, it was bad. But so it was just really upsetting. Just it's and always
mention, you, you didn't even mention it. Nobody knew the hot to go Dan.
Oh, so yeah, like that's
at
what
jelly
started
or
like,
at
jelly rolls. So like that's what started the whole like what's wrong with, because that was when we first got there. Like we walk in, they started playing hot to go. So I was like, oh my God, yeah, I'm back there doing the dance. I asked Jace to film me doing the dance to send to the group chat. Did you guys see this? Did you see the video that's in the group chat?
I saw a video. It wasn't much.
It's not much. You have to scroll. I give the phone to Jace. I go, will you record me dancing to send it to the group chat? I go back to look at it. It is a video of me to start and then a video of the floor. This man did not record. And I was like, I think I sicked
those Gen Zs on Jace.
Yeah. You're like, hey, this is it.
Here you go,
you went to your group, your Gen Z group chat.
Uh-huh.
Are you watching
get over
that?
There. If they're once they get out of jail, little blonde
watching
one.
The video. The little blonde
it's,
boy.
It's literally
immediate, just down. I was like, oh, okay. So yeah, immediately nobody knew hot to go. I'm back there like screaming it, like, you have people back here who know it. This is not, it's not all for naught type of thing. So that's what set
that's
it off.
Crazy. Cause I, okay. Atlantic Dance Hall, the vibe that's always like hit and miss. You never know. Yeah. You don't know what you're going to get. What convention
free
is
cover,
in town.
Cheap you know? Drink. Is it still $4 beers? Have they upped the price yet?
I don't remember. We didn't get a drink there. So I don't know.
I don't remember it being that cheap.
No, well, it was that was one of their like, at least like until COVID, you could go in there, and that was the one place on Disney property you could get a $4 beer.
Wow.
That, yeah. But Jelly Rolls, I would assume that the vibe you would all, just because, yeah, just from the sole purpose that people have to pay to get in there.
Yeah, like, you have to pay. It's a Saturday night before a holiday week. Like, you would think it would be a bopping good time.
Yeah.
And no, she was not. I mean, we had fun, our little pod. But the vibes, it would have been so much better if people just didn't suck.
It was not a bop. It was a flop.
Was a flop, for sure. But yeah, so.
Casey, do you want to go? Do you have
something? Yeah, I'll go.
Okay.
Go. Okay.
Go ahead, Casey. Go off.
Okay, here's my go off. And it's why is... like baking so difficult. So like I'm trying to make some buttercream. And then I realize after making the buttercream and tasting it, I'm like, this just tastes like fucking butter. And then I go on Reddit, and everyone on Reddit is like, well, yeah, if you make American buttercream, it's just butter and sugar. So it just tastes like butter. And you gotta do this, you gotta do that. I'm like, why is this so hard? Like, I'm thinking I'm going to be like a cool little like baking queen diva. And like, but no, I make this buttercream, and it is just so either butter or then sugar. And then I put too much sugar in it. So then I kept tasting it. And now my stomach hurts because I've had too much damn sugar trying to taste this icing. And then I just get icing from the store because Miss Buttercream is she's a mess. She's just sugar and butter.
Sugar, butter, flour.
Buttercream's tough.
Frosting is tough. Like frosting is like the hardest thing. I would make cookies all the time if I could figure out frosting. Like I could never get it correct.
On like the baking shows, they're just like putting some stuff together and they've got it and it's like so easy. And
it looks
so
easy.
Literally even the sugar packet tells you the recipe for buttercream on it. Cause it's like, you're going to make buttercream with this, but
right.
And then also, okay, this is probably also on me, but I put my butter in the fridge. So I had I'd let it sit out so it could be at room temperature or whatever. Yeah. But then it's like, do you ever like taste your butter? And it's like, my butter kind of tastes like all of the food in my fridge.
No, because I keep. Do you not keep it in like the little container?
I keep it in the butter thing.
Oh,
but like RJ, do you ever get that to where like your butter just kind of tastes like the food in your fridge? Like it's like this isn't like an appealing.
It's in a butter container, or is it just in the?
It's. It was wrapped up in the box,
in the little thing, the
butter crisper.
I think you just had bad butter, Diva.
Bad butter. I must just have some bad head butter. My H-E-B butter.
Bad head butter. You gotta do Irish carry Irish gold.
Man, that's some good butter.
That's the girl. Man, that's the girl.
Isn't it weird? Like back in like my main baking days was when I was dairy free. So like all of my butter was like the Earth Balance butter. Like sad to think about, honestly. But that's when I would bake the most for some reason.
Earth Balance.
Earth Balance.
I had Earth Balance back in the day.
I like it. It's good.
Yeah.
I mean, for what you need it.
Next time I make a buttercream, I'm using Country Crock.
Bitch.
Honestly, say less. I love Country Crock. You know what? Also, there's no harm in. I just can't believe it's not butter margarine. Like that shit is also just as well.
Spray. Get the spray.
Get the spray. But not, I had a little piece of toast this morning. Yeah.
With it? Yeah. It's perfectly spreadable. Perfectly period.
Spreadable. I love it. I put it on my Target list because I ran out this morning when I put it on my toast. I was like,
my mommy, when we first moved to America, that was like the butter that she like discovered, like, oh, butter margarine combo. I can't believe it's not butter. So, yeah, I was putting that on.
Very Joy Silva.
It was like that. Okay, so this was when we first moved to America. It was like, I can't believe it's not butter. Costco croissant sandwiches, like you know just like croissant sandwiches in general, and Thomas bagels. She went crazy on Thomas bagels. She was like she's like, it's so much better than regular bread.
Oh my god.
Whenever I like got to college and I was buying my own groceries, I would buy Wonder Bread. Because I always wanted it as a kid.
And you never did.
And we never got it. So I was buying fucking Wonder Bread, being like, wow, this is the
I've lap really
of
made
luxury.
It, Diva.
I've That's made right. it. I can do what I want.
Yeah.
The show Adam and I were in together, it was like a short play called Car Baby. I gave birth to a baby in a car. Adam played my pet armadillo, but these people were like white trash. Like they were country hicks and they had Wonder Bread. And it makes me think of my old professor who just passed away last week. It was very sad.
We found out while we were recording the pod, American Girl.
Recording American Girl. That's when we got the text. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's very sad. I loved him so much. And RJ famously based one of his characters that I directed off of him. I was like, play Jonathan Wilson. And RJ was like, say less. I got it. But he was in the audience. And you just hear him go, when we pull out the Wonder Bread, you just hear him go, Wonder Bread. it was just like an iconic moment. But no, Wonder Bread is so... Well, you love it. It's great. And I can't say much. Like, I get, like, the shit keto bread that's, like, at Costco. And it's, like, it's this like, isn't. Okay. Yeah.
You go to, like Japan and, like, you see all these, like, TikTok recipes where they just make the cutest shit and, like, the tastiest shit with just, like, plain white Wonder Bread. So people are doing stuff with them.
And honestly, a beach sandwich with like mayonnaise and lettuce and tomato
on like a cold Wonder Bread. Ugh.
Oh my god, yeah! And then you have it at a beach like 3 hours later. That's iconic. That's
that's
summer
the softest
staple.
Bread you're ever gonna have.
Honey. You love that mushiness at the beach. Mm-hmm. You put some little potato chips in it. Ugh.
A little bologna, and Kraft single cheese.
Mom used to do Wonder Bread, Country Crock, sliced cheese.
Wow.
That was it. It's a snack.
Amazing.
I used to just eat a piece of bread with Country Crock on it, untoasted with like spaghetti and stuff.
I do
like
that.
My mom would make me that, like with
Casey. I was literally who was I talking to about this the other day?
Spaghetti?
Jace! No, I was talking to Jace about it. I was like, oh, I would love making my little spaghetti sandwiches, and he was like, what? I was like, you never did spaghetti that. Yes,
in the bread.
Yes, just like Casey said, you would take white bread, put butter on it, and then you'd put your little spaghetti on it and make a little spaghetti sandwich. It's so good. I was just talking about that. Ugh, amazing. Or I would put like just a piece of Kraft singles on the white bread and put it in the microwave for 30 seconds.
Oh, yeah. Oh, girl, I would do whole kernel corn, put it in a bowl, put the Crunchy Crock and Kraft American singles, put it in there.
Cheesy corn.
Instant cheesy corn.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Never made that. That sounds
These are like my latchkey kid recipes. When my mom was like, I'm not coming home till like 9, so make something for your brother.
Figure it out.
Oh, honey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'd be at Meemaw's looking for a snack, and it would be taquitos. It'd be those like taquitos that you get and you just put in the microwave, or it would be like a hot dog, no buns, but just a hot dog,
never
a piece of white bread,
piece of white bread.
Yes,
yeah, or the bologna sandwich.
Yeah,
man.
Okay, I will go.
Yes, RJ, go off.
It's been so nice out, shockingly, here in Chicago. I don't know why it's like not summer, but it's been like nice and I'm not complaining. So I was like, well, I'm gonna go on a run. Let's go crazy. Let's go on a run. I ran for like a mile and 1.20 something. And I was like, oh, okay, whew, I think that's it. I'm done. And then on the way back, I was like, well, you know, I need to grab stuff at the grocery store anyway. So let me just grab stuff at the grocery store and then come back. And then like 8 o'clock hits later that night and I have the worst headache that I've ever had that truly has lasted until I want to say like 2 o'clock today. And I was like, okay, I remember this happening a lot in Orlando. And every time I would like do cardio specifically, I would like get a really bad headache, but like, or like when I would run. But then I was like, but I run at the gym. What if I'm like spending time at the gym, I'll do like a quick mile before I like start working out. And then I realized, I think it's just because like at the gym, because you're in there, it's contained. I have my Awala next to me. I'm not even thinking about it. I'm just drinking and I'm just going. But when you're outside and you're just running, you don't feel the need to, you just don't feel it. You just be, and it's so nice and you're just going. And then I come back and I'm like, oh yeah, I did not drink any. I lost so much water and I did not drink any. So, sometimes you're just not a running outside girly, which is so sad because Chicago summers are so beautiful and you really want to do it. You see these people happily running outside.
The lakeshore
runners.
And you
want to do it so bad.
You always want to be that person. You're like, you know what? I'm going to take up beach volleyball.
Beach volleyball.
I'm
going to
take up running on the lakeshore. And you never do.
They look so happy.
They look like they have their lives together. Like
all of these like finance bros and marketing girlies. Yes. Just happy to be out in the sun. And I do like one 20-minute run. And I'm like... I was like in bed all morning.
No, I cannot run outside. I mean, famously, I don't run anymore, but I could. Like, it was so much easier for me to run on a treadmill than to run outside back in the day.
Yeah, because you know why? On the treadmill, I can pop a little YouTube music video playlist, honey.
Yeah.
And I am just running while watching all these music videos.
You're still recording?
Yes, we talked about we spent 5 minutes talking about Wonder Bread.
Yeah.
Adam, did you?
Yeah, you missed it.
At spaghetti dinners, did you used to have like a piece of bread and then you would put the spaghetti on the bread and then eat it?
No.
Your piece of bread with your butter on it and then the
spaghetti. No.
Because
my mom was very into dinner rolls.
Oh, you're fancy.
Fancy.
Well, sure.
Coming from a woman who microwaved potatoes and said, I made you a baked
potato. Listen, sometimes it's easier to do. Sometimes.
Yeah, you just take the fork and you...
Stab it. Pop it in there. Well, great. Now that Adam's back, I think it's time to end the show. So thanks, everyone, for listening. Don't forget, close friends, you get 3 bonus episodes a month. We just talked about Miranda's trip to the bayou. And then for the rest of the month,
going down the bayou.
You'll
going
hear,
down the bayou.
You'll hear about Cosmix/Blaze. And then you'll hear about a single rider.
Single rider summer.
Single rider summer. It's going to be a marathon of stories. So get your popcorn.
I've got my notes app ready.
Who's your special guest for that one? I forgot.
Yeah, who is your special?
It's Miranda.
I don't know. It's technically Miranda, but I feel like I gotta save. Well, you're Miranda going for you're... a more Disney one.
Well, she's also going on a cruise, so.
Yeah. Do you have any upside down pineapple ones that you could share with Miranda?
That's a good idea. Oh,
just for tips and tricks more than anything else.
Yes, of course. Me and my grandma.
Yeah, do you need me to make you any
decals?
Door decorations?
Yes.
No,
I made all these door decorations. Here's my go off. I made all these door decorations for my sister and she left half of them at home. Like, I'm like, I laminated. I'm never making shit you.
That's sad.
So yeah, so stay tuned for that. Otherwise, come back here next week. Thank you, girlies, for joining. Thank you, girlies in the chat who have all left now, I'm sure. And thanks, bye, everyone. Don't forget to read the group chat. Goodbye.
Bye, y'all.
Bye, y'all.
Thanks for listening to the show. You can find us on Instagram @DidYouReadThePod and TikTok @DidYouReadTheGroupChat. You can also join the group chat on Facebook and the Discord server. Links on the episode details. The best way to support the show is by sharing the podcast to your friends and by leaving ratings and reviews. You can leave a 5-star rating on Spotify and a 5-star review on Apple Podcasts, and we'll read them on the show. Our theme, KK Cruise and Lo-Fi, is by Closed on Sunday. Find their music on Spotify and YouTube as Closed on Sunday. See you next time, besties, and don't forget to read the group chat.